Well, Tuesdays are all about the minors, and joining me here is UTEP head football coach Dana Dimmel. Coach Dimmel, thanks for coming in again.
Adrian, great to be on.
Coming off a 52-21 tough loss at UT San Antonio, would you say you hadn't played two games? You've gone 2 weeks without playing a game. Would you factor that into the performance on last Saturday?
You know, I felt like it. You know, it took a toll on us. You know, what took a toll on us more than anything, Adrian, was the fact that we just, you know, lost some players. You know, we were down quite a few players for the game and thought we played really, really well in the first half. But in the second half, we had to throw some guys in that had hardly been practicing, and the other team found them and exposed them a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Well, you had a game scheduled for UAB this week originally at home. Then last week it was moved to Midland, but ultimately canceled because UAB had some COVID issues on their side. How do you approach this week now? What are you planning to do?
Well, you know, again, this week is a week that gives us some more time to prepare for Rice. It gives us a chance to get some of our guys back, which is going to be really important for us. Towards the end of the week, we should start to get quite a few of our guys back that missed the game last week, and then obviously get some guys healed up that are beat up a little bit. So that's the advantage in not playing this weekend.
What were just some of your takeaways from that UTSA game? Things that you learned, things that you need to...
Sure. Yeah, the UTSA, we're learning all the time. You know, obviously I decided, even though we were beat up pretty good for various reasons, to play the game because I want our guys to continue to play, continue to get better, continue to improve. I thought we played a first half like we've been playing all season, very, very competitive. It was very frenetic at the end of the first half, a lot of scoring in the last 3 minutes of the first half. But the second half, when we lost the lead there late in the first half, we didn't respond. You know, we came out and didn't score on the first drive, you know, moved the ball a little bit but did not score. And then they went down and scored right away. And then the next drive we had the turnover, which led to a score. And all of a sudden the game that was very, very tight ended up being a 3-score lead for them.
How difficult is it for you just not having that game action and then all of a sudden being thrust into a game?
You know, it was difficult. The transition was difficult. There was definitely some ring rust, which I was very concerned about. It showed itself. You know, what really showed itself more than anything is the turnovers that we had. We needed to create more turnovers than we did, and we had the costly turnovers there in the ball game that really, you know, were very decisive in the victory.
Well, you knew this season was going to be a grind, no doubt, just with all the postponements, cancellations. Here you are, not quite at the finish line just yet, but how has everything been going for you, and how have you been able to handle this, just the fluctuation?
Oh, you know, I visited with some other head coaches today, and we're all just, you know, it's just been a crazy year with all the things that we've had to deal with. There's multitude of things you have to deal with as a head coach, and it's just important now to really look at all the positives that we've garnered from this year. We've improved so much. We got a lot of good players, and now we've got to regroup, get everybody back healthy, you know, back working and practicing so we can go out and play the way we've been playing throughout most of the season.
UTEP's next game on the road in Houston against Rice, November 28th. Coach Dimmel, thank you very much for taking the time.
Thanks, Adrian. Appreciate it.